audience all over the world, a very warm welcome to our talk with our chairman, Calvin Greder, and our CEO, Stefan Scheiber. 2020 was such a turbulent year, many events, many surprises, ups and downs, many emotions. Now, I want to reflect with Calvin and Stefan about this year, what we learned from it, and how we will move on. Welcome, Calvin and Stefan.
Hello, everybody.
Now, 2020, looking back from your perspective and experience, was that a lost year?
Well, Burkhard, I believe not at all, not at all. I think that would be much too simplistic. Yes, of course, it was a year of crisis, a year of many unexpected things which happened. Also a year where we had a lower top line development. Yes, for instance, the automotive situation has also affected our business. But then again, on the other side, the improvements in the food business. But it was also a year where we learned a lot in terms of, for instance, collaboration or digitalization. So by no means it was a lost year, Burkhard.
Calvin, what would you add to that?
Well, it depends where you're looking to. I mean, around us, a lot of things happened. And I would say for, I'm sure, many years, we will have certainly quite a financial burden to take on. We will have also a lot of people, you know, that fell into poverty again. So I think around that, there are certainly a few things to consider. If I look at our company, I would say, you know, to be a family, own company, to be long-term orientated, to have a broad portfolio was certainly a good advantage. And from there, I think we can be happy as a company.
Now, I mean, every one of us also personally was heavily affected by this situation, right? So everyone had to deal with the families, with the companies, and so on and so forth. What are your, from a personal perspective, your key experiences and key learnings?
Burkhard, when I start, then I must say it was the year of communication. I think it never in my career I have communicated so intensively, so often, also in new formats, of course. It was the year where I believe leadership was more important than ever. On the other side also, I would say team spirit, sort of the feeling of belonging to one company and work for a purpose, more than just for, like say, the next month-end result. These are very important learnings and takeaways from me personally out of 2020.
Calvin, what would you comment on that?
Well, I agree. Leadership played an important role. A lot of things have changed from the beginning of the year, which we would have never thought about. So adapting to the changing world, I think, was very important. We had to set priorities. The management had to set priorities because you could, of course, get lost into all the turbulences that happened. And in the end, I feel, you know, showing optimism and trust to everybody was very important to solve the issues we had.
Now, when we look at our financial performance, I mean, this is plays also an important role. It turned out that we are quite robust in that kind of challenging environment. What are the reasons behind that robustness and resilience, Stefan, if you...
Well, Calvin has alluded to that topic already. I think we again benefited from the fact that Bühler has a very broad portfolio. We are in the, you know, staple food processing technologies. We are in consumer foods. We are in advanced materials. And we have also not really stopped. In fact, we have accelerated the topic of innovation throughout the whole year of 2020. After all, it was the 160-year birthday of our company. And we said, of course, even in a crisis situation, we are not going to give up on innovation. In fact, we add even more to it. And if you look at our figures, then you will actually see that as well. And we we came out with some very relevant new innovations into the markets last year, and I believe this is really very important to remain creative, to not give up on a belief of building a good future of a company which is 160 years old. Then obviously there is the aspect of also our global setup. Well, we had 100 service stations, we have more than 30 factories in the markets for the markets, and this infrastructure, this network has helped us, even if we could not travel, for instance, because of travel bans, to be with our customers locally. And I think that made the difference. We also honored all our contracts on time. And that was very, very important in 2020, because many of our food customers particularly, they are relevant, very relevant, and very important industries in a situation of a crisis and a pandemic situation.
Well, you know, from my side, I think I can only say we were very thankful that we had a management team that, you know, immediately set out the priorities, made it very clear that they want to keep the people safe, because a company without the people cannot operate anymore. So all our sites were in operation all around these difficult times. And on the other side, you know, immediately securing that we have enough cash and we can keep the company safe and ongoing for the future. So, I mean, this was really very well done, and I'm very happy that we got through this crisis. Well, it's not over yet, but so far so good. And I would like to thank all the management, all the employees for really keeping safe and keeping the operations up. Thank you very much.
Now, Calvin, you already touched upon that topic, and you are in your position dealing a lot with companies from a leadership perspective. Now, talking about culture, I guess 2020 also gave us a strong lesson in terms of leadership, right? What are the takeaways in this regard, Calvin, to you?
Well, I mentioned it before, you know, the leaders that got lost in this crisis had a hard time. I think really to keep the focus, to keep the trust and the optimism within the company and make the right moves to adapt quickly to the situation that has changed drastically. I mean, who had thought that immediately, you know, half of the company would stay at home and do business from home? If I would have told you this a year ago, you would have laughed at me that this is possible. We did it overnight, and I think that was true leadership, and I have seen that in other companies as well.
Now, Stefan, from a leadership perspective, I guess empathy has become much more important, right? So what are your experiences in this regard?
Well, absolutely, Burkhard. I think you hit it on the nail. On one important leadership sentence, which I believe was really touching my heart last year, was the sentence which says, people want to be heard on the one hand side, and people want to be led. So the empathy part, the part where you are sensitive about the frustrations, the anxieties of people, the uncertainties, was very important, because nobody of us has ever experienced something like that, at least not me in my lifetime. And on the other hand, it was very important, even more important, to be very clear about priorities, about focal points. We had to unite our teams across the globe according to some key priorities, and that helped us then to also align the energies and focus on some common goals which would actually take us through this crisis last year and most probably also for a good part of this year. So it was both aspects, and then also, as I said, this aspect of believing in getting over this, creating perspectives for the future, because I think people can do quite a lot if they believe there is a positive end to it. And this is why also we never gave up in innovating. We also, you know, as Calvin has said, you know, not only did we create the ability to have thousands of our employees in virtual work, but also we created the virtual world, or also a platform like this one now, Burkhard, where we do our annual report in a completely new way. So all of this is, I think, very important and were very important characteristics of last year.
Now, talking about future, Calvin, the impact mid to long term of the situation, what do you think will change, what will stay, how will a new normality will look like? So what is the impact looking going forward?
Well, as I said before, I don't think that we just go back to normal. I mean, we talk a lot about the new bipolar world, and we often think about West and East, more the politics, and you can even talk about US Democrats and Republicans. But I mean, there is also another bipolar world. If you talk about the rich and the poor, I think this gap will widen. So I mean, this is something we have to take into consideration. I also feel that, you know, the financial systems are a little bit different. They are more vulnerable for the future. So I think we will have to be careful, and even things like cybersecurity, you know, I mean, a world like this becomes immediately very sensitive to any such, let's say, disturbance, and can immediately give a lot of turbulence. So I would be careful for the future. I'm not that I'm pessimistic. No, I'm actually seeing a lot of opportunities, because, you know, every crisis offers a lot of opportunities. But I think we will have to watch out, and we will have to be careful. I don't expect that we just go back to normal. This crisis can still go on, and this crisis can still mean quite a few changes for the future.
Stefan, from a CEO perspective, running the company.
Well, I couldn't agree more to the our chairman's note before, and perhaps even over and beyond of that. I believe, I'm truly convinced that companies with a strong purpose will win eventually, and Bühler has this very strong purpose. I think another important learning is that whilst we now focused on the health part of the crisis for and then the economic subsequences and about that, we now realize that obviously the sustainability topic will come back and actually be even more important. And there I also believe it's important that we continue to position ourselves to come up with new solutions, because the question now is, more people are in poverty as a consequence of this health crisis. So we have an economic crisis and a social crisis as well. What are the solutions which Bühler provides for this going forward? Here we have some very cool ideas also addressing these needs. So purpose, innovation, and people most probably are the magic formula for success. People in the center, the topic of training and education. Also this sort of agility, most probably what we are going to see is that the periods where relative stability prevails are shorter. So the constant change is most probably a fact going forward. And as our chairman has just said, you know, yes, there are challenging things and critical things which we need to take very seriously. And at the other side, also see the opportunities. And if we do that, then we can also be very optimistic about the future. I believe we need to show a certain sense of optimism going forward, because optimism is a strategy for making a better future, because unless you believe that the future can be better, it's unlikely you will step up and take the responsibility for making it so. So this is not me who has said that, but Mr. Chomsky. But I believe in this, and in that sense, being cautious, being aware of all the challenges, I'm optimistic for the future.
So, gentlemen, thanks so much. Now, before we close, Calvin, as our chairman, do you have a special last message to our employees, partners, customers, or stakeholders who are watching Bühler?
Well, I certainly after this year, a year which I think stood out in at least my short life, I would like to thank all our employees, our partners and our customers especially for keeping with us, for trying to keep each other safe, to keep our operations up and running. But I think also to have the spirit and to have the will to adapt to a completely different world, to make the necessary changes. And with that, I can also share the optimism that Stefan had. And I wish you all the best. Thanks a lot for all your great work. And yeah, I hope for better times, of course, in the future. All the best to you all.
So thanks, Calvin, and thanks, Stefan, for our talk. Now, ladies and gentlemen, with this we end our talk here. Thank you for dialing in, for participating. All the best, stay healthy, and with this optimism, I think we can manage the future in a very good way. Thank you.